All hail a beard, it's your boy Big Beard B, and we back for another edition of Big Beard Business. Look, man, today is Saturday. You know what that means. That means we are back for another weekly fragrance rotation video. Man, we moving. Today, we talk about number 6, man. So, as you guys know how this goes, I tell you what I wore this week. You know, I tell you how many sprays, if I got compliments, this, that, and the third. And you comment below and let me know what you wore this week. So, let's get into it. Oh, actually, before we get into it, I want to share something with you guys, man. I got some new pickups that I picked up today, and I want to know which one you guys want to hear about first. So, this one was new. I looked at it, and I didn't see any reviews, so I bought it. You guys let me know. This one is Mr. Burberry Indigo. I don't know what it smells like, but if you guys want to see the first impressions early next week, comment below and let me know what are your thoughts on this one if you want to see it. So you can know if you get your nose on it or not. Also, I picked up the latest release from Armani. And this one is Acqua di Gio Absolute. And I don't know anything about this one. I knew it was coming. And the bottle looked a lot different than I thought it was going to look. But purchased that one. And I also purchased Valentino Uomo Intense. Very dope fragrance there. And if you guys are wondering, you're probably not wondering, but I'm gonna tell you, Dillard's, if you have a Dillard's near you, they are running a buy one get one 50% off. So I bought 3 fragrances for me, one for my wife. She got a big grandpappy bottle of Juicy Couture Majestic Woods. If you're into dark fragrances, or if your lady's into dark fragrances, you might like that one. Get your nose on it. It comes on this Tom Ford-esque type packaging. She didn't know I was picking it up, so I was like, oh, this was the best fragrance of them all. So she looked at it, had it turned the wrong way. She's like, this looks like the biggest fucking bottle of Tom Ford I've ever seen, because the packages are very similar. But obviously it was not. Guess what I got on that? Let's get into what I wore this week. So on Sunday, I revisited one of my favorite fragrances. It's not anything expensive. It's not like, you know, overly, it doesn't have like the best quality, but it gets compliments and I like it. Now, when I show you guys this bottle, do not laugh at me. I told you I need a new bottle, but I haven't purchased one because I've been buying other things. And I don't think I'm gonna have much of a choice left now because it's pretty low. On Sunday, I wore Burberry Touch for Men. Look how low this is. This is 2-3 sprays max is what I have left on this one. And I thoroughly enjoy this one. I wish I could get like a grandpappy bottle, you know, the big ones, like boom! Those like Muga cologne type bottles. I wish I could get that with this one. This one is, oh, the notes are here. It's woody, musky, and aromatic. It's a great fragrance. I like it. This one has been like a signature scent for me, I guess. If I had a signature scent, let me rephrase that. It was a signature scent like back in high school, right? I wear this now like for bed, lazy days, which I have a lot of lazy days. But lazy days when I don't do anything at all, like nothing. Like, I'm just going to get in the bed. And the missus likes it because this reminds her when we first got together-ish back in, you know, back in high school. She wasn't, like, mine yet, but she was mine. You know, when you just take her, like, come here, girl. Yeah, you know where you belong. Sunday. Boy, obviously, I didn't wear too many sprays because I don't have much left. I need to buy this. You guys comment below and say, buy Burberry Touch. Buy Burberry Touch. Dope. Super dope. On Monday, I visited the house of Hugo Boss, and I wore the scent. This one is one that I've recently got in the collection. I showed you guys this one came courtesy, not courtesy, because I bought it. This one came by way of fragrancebuy.ca. I did a video on this recently at the fragrance buying guide. I'll link that down below. If you guys haven't heard about it, make sure you check it out, because this is really dope video series that I have for you guys. But I wore this one, man. I got this one in that box, and I've been waiting for this one for so long, because I would smell it in stores, like, damn, I want it, but I would never buy it. I would buy other things. And I bought this one. So I like it. I think it's an incredible fragrance. I did about 5 sprays on this one on Monday when I wore it. It did get me compliments. I got about 3 compliments with this one. It stood out. This is a standout fragrance. I thoroughly enjoy it. Make sure you get your nose on it. One of the best for the house, if you ask me. And the missus loves it, so. Duh. On Tuesday, I visited a fragrance that I talked to you guys about in my spring, in my top 10 spring list. If you haven't seen that, make sure you watch it. What are you doing? This one comes from the House of Commodity, and it's Commodities Velvet. This one is a newer release from the house. I put you guys up on game on this one. I have not done a full review on this one yet, but put yourself in the mind of Replicas by the Fireplace, and you pretty much have this one. It's a lot lighter. It has a rose in it. It's super nice. I mean, check it out. At the very least, go check it out. Get your nose on. I did about 5 sprays on this. I didn't do too much on Tuesday. I don't know if I did anything on Tuesday. I think Tuesday I got in an argument with my bank. It wasn't really an argument. It was me venting that I was very frustrated with their fuckery. All right, and they better fix it because they haven't fixed it yet. I don't know what y'all doing, but I will expose you. Tuesday, we also picked up some, these benches from my wife's multiple makeup stations in her makeup room, I guess, or like this office type of thing. She picked up these benches that she ordered from American Signature. So they came in and I put those together because that's what husbands do. Except I did not hang her chandelier for there, because so that I did not do. If any of you guys want to come and hang that for me, let me know, baby. Let me know. Wednesday, I revisited another fragrance that I picked up from fragrancebuy.ca. Again, if you haven't seen that video, check it out because I'm putting you guys up on game. This one was from the House of Cree and it's Vetiver Geranium. Spring, summer, nice. This is a nice spring and summer fragrance. It's very light. It's a nice take on vetiver. I've talked about this one in the sax vlog. I've talked about this one in the unboxing video for the fragrance buying guide. I'm not sure how much more I need to say on this one. I wore 5 sprays of this one, got some compliments. Not many. I think I got about 2 compliments. I enjoy it, man. I actually told a few people about this one in Snapchat and on Instagram. And they purchased it. They are happy with their purchases. So, job well done. Good job, Big Beer B. Good job, buddy. Sometimes you gotta give yourself a round of applause because there's haters out there. You know what I'm saying? So you gotta cheer yourself on. Don't let them get you down. Don't never, never, ever, ever, ever let them get you down. Thursday was kind of a busy day. I had to get up early, man. I had a meeting. You know, I hate sitting in these meetings. You know, I gotta go in there, be listening, blah, blah, blah. Hey, what do you think? And I gotta tell them what I think. And then, you know, they'll be like, oh, I think like that too. And I'm like, oh, no, you don't. Da-da-da-da. You don't think like me, because I don't think like you. No, just joking, man. Meetings are cool. I like meetings. You get to see people. You know, I get to wear fragrances around them and make them jealous. But on Thursday, I wore Green Irish Tweed. Damn, I wish I had the actual beard oil with me right now. I don't feel like walking to go get it. I paired this up with a beard oil from Dua Fragrances, and it is pretty much like a splitting image of this one. I talked about it in my top 3 beard oils based on scent a while ago, and this is one of the only beard oils, in my opinion, that you should pair up with this one. Complements it extremely well. Most of my beard oils, you know, they got either like zesty or they're like minty, or they even have that dark, rich fragrance type of feel to it, but it pairs extremely well with this one. I'll find that video and link it below so you guys can check it, or at the very least, I'll find the beard oil itself so you can check it out. I did 5 sprays on this one. As you guys typically know, unless I'm giving a meeting to my direct employees, I typically go meet with my team about 1.5 hours away. That's what I did, man. I went and met with my team, had a meeting there, went 5 sprays on this one, and obviously you already know how that one performs, so I don't need to say much about it. And we're in the spring. So what better time to wear Green Irish Tweed is in the spring. Now Friday was a bit of a twist because on Thursday, we had good weather. On Friday, we had a little cooler weather. And listen, I know you guys are dealing with some frigid temperatures other places out there. But this is Florida, man. I pay to live in paradise, okay? I pay to have the sun here all the time on command, okay? And it did not come when I tell it to come. And I don't like that, all right? So what I had to do, just because it started with stunting on me, the sun thought it was gonna stunt on me, I pulled out, you know, by the fireplace from the homies over at Mason Martin Margiela or Triple M or Replica, whatever you guys wanna call them, man. Super, super dope fragrance. And this one goes back to saying that how I feel that commodity and by the fireplace are really close, right? So I had to do a few interviews. Actually, I only did one interview Friday. I did some interviews somewhere else around this time because I'm hiring a manager, right? And I did an interview, okay, with one of these fragrances. I can't remember what. But one of my employees, I'm walking past him. He like, hey, you got the same thing on you wore the other day? Because I know you typically don't like to wear the same thing in a row. I'm like, you know what? I don't know what you talk about. Not thinking about it. And I totally gave him the shutdown, like, shut up. You don't know what you're talking about. Get back to work. It was one of those type things. But I was like, oh, you know what, man? I apologize because I did have... I did have this one on, and I had to remember which one I had on. I looked at my list, like, which one did I wear? I'm like, oh, he's so right. He is so right. So I went back to him, apologized, you know, like, hey, look, man, I apologize. You're right. See, what happened was, it was this new fragrance that I was wearing, and it's very similar, and I didn't think you knew what you was talking about, but you proved my point that they are similar. So he was okay with that. I think I did four or five sprays on this one. This one, again, smells like you are just by a campfire. It's like roasted marshmallows. You got some almond in here, vanilla. Very nice fragrance. I love it. It's burning wood and chestnut is their description. Look at the review on that if you haven't checked it out. This one is available at your Sephora's. It's available at Barney's. Check it out, man. I'll link it below. And today, Saturday, I wore a fragrance that I have not worn in quite some time, but I was like, you know what? Mr. Weather, because it was like 62 this morning. I'm like, I reached for another fragrance. And I ended up coming out with this one. So I'm like, you know what? I'm going to wear this one. So I wore some Ultramar today. It served me well, man. I missed you, man. You know, I haven't worn this one in quite some time. And, you know, it felt good to be reunited. You guys know about this one. Ultramar is a beast. This one's beastly. Okay, it's getting down to its pecs now. So you can tell I wear it because I have a lot of fragrances and down to its pecs. I remember my first experience with this one. I thought that this fragrance made me sick. Like I didn't know I was sick. I was like, oh, I feel terrible. Maybe I'm allergic to this one. We were going Halloween shopping for my kids like the first month that this came out, years ago. I sprayed it, we're riding in the car. I'm like, oh. My nose and stuff was all feeling crazy. And it wasn't prior to smelling this one. So I had a perfect reason to blame it on this one. And I refused to wear this one. Actually, I refused to try this one out again for quite some time because I just associated those memories with it. Then I went and bought it once again. It's here. Really nice fragrance. I went four sprays on that one, not too much. You guys know that one projects, performs like a monster, and gets very good longevity, so you don't really need much from that one. And then obviously I showed you guys what I picked up today. So comment below and let me know, what did you do today? What did you wear this week, and what was the best piece of your week? I don't know, best part of your week, not piece. I mean, unless you got a piece, then you can comment below that too. And look, man, one last thing before we go. I was talking to one of my subscribers the other day on Instagram, and he was saying his wife, his old lady, I don't know if it's his girlfriend, his wife, his boo thing, you know what I'm saying? He was saying that she be giving him problems because he be taking up the TV to watch me. Look, Michelle, all right, you need to sit down every day, all right? Support your man in his fragrance journey, all right? You need to join the Big Bib movement as well. B-Gang, Michelle, you need to join, okay? You know, I'm entertaining, okay? I'm funny. I'm better than Love and Hip Hop, baby. Make sure you sit down and watch me, okay? All right, Michelle, please. Please, please subscribe too. I mean, let him watch me, okay? I mean, he gonna get a TV back, okay? I mean, just the TV is better than a little phone. Big Bib Business needs to be watched on the big screen, babe. Shout out to you though, Michelle, all right? All jokes aside, shout out to you. Thank you for supporting him while he watches me. I'm your boy, Big Bib. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, tell a friend to tell a friend that we are back again. And do me a favor, say it with me. Hit the goddamn bell. Hopefully you said it along with me. If you didn't, double click on your screen to go back 10, 15, 20 seconds to that point and say it, goddamn it. Boom.